Greetings, fellow nerds. In a previous video, I showed that pyrolytic graphite was diamagnetic and could be stably levitated over some magnets. Unfortunately, pyrolytic graphite is very expensive for the amateur, not really worth buying if all you're going to do is look at it and poke it a few times. As it turns out, some types of pencil lead, which is actually graphite, is also diamagnetic and can be levitated. It's not as strong, but it still works. Now first you need to find pencil lead that's diamagnetic. To do this, just lay it out and approach it with the poles of a magnet. It should move away. This proves the graphite is diamagnetic and will always be repelled by the magnet. Not all pencil lead will do this though. Some have iron filings or other magnetic materials that will actually be attracted by a magnet. If this is the case, you'll need to find another brand of pencil lead. Also, the pencil lead should be as thin as possible. This one is 0.5 millimeters. Thicker leads have lower cross-sectional area to volume ratio and thus will be too heavy to levitate. Now let's get started. First, you'll need to arrange an array of small but strong neodymium magnets in a checkerboard fashion with alternating north and south faces. I'm using round magnets, but square magnets are also fine. Once it's laid out, just place the pencil lead on top. And there you go, it is levitating. It's not as high as pure pyrolytic graphite, but it's visible. The best position I found was this diagonal 2x1 magnet orientation. It's most stable and you can press on it without it falling off easily. You can try a straight orientation, but as you can see here, it's much more delicate and needs a little jiggling to get into just the right spot. It's a tad higher than the 2x1 diagonal orientation, but as you can see, just touch it and it falls off. A 1x1 diagonal does not levitate at all, so stick with the 2x1. Let's see now, this is the best we can do to levitate it. But is there any way to levitate it even higher? We cannot use a thicker pencil lead as mentioned before. Using stronger magnets is an option, but a much cheaper approach is to add another upward force to the pencil lead. How do we do that? We cheat by using water. Simply place the magnet array in a container of water. Place the pencil lead in and you'll find it floats noticeably higher than before. This is a great demonstration of the property of buoyancy. The pencil lead displaces an equal volume of water and therefore experiences an upward force of the weight of the water that was displaced. This added buoyant force pushes the pencil lead higher. And there you have it. We apply the separate concepts of diamagnetism and buoyancy to levitate pencil lead. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, rate, and comment.